So today we are going to learn about social, political and economic developments and challenges in Kenya since independence. And as we all understand, is Kenya gained independence in 1963 from the then colonial master, which is Britain. And when it gained independence in 1963, Kenya inherited a lot of problems from the colonial government. And those problems range from political, social, and economic. So in this topic, we are going to analyze the social developments and challenges, political developments and challenges, and economic developments and challenges. So all those political, social, economic developments and challenges have been summarized as ignorance, poverty, and diseases. So we want to begin by seeing the political developments from 1963 to 1991. Political developments from 1963 to 1991. That's our first part as we dissect this topic. So Kenya inherited a number of political problems from the colonial governments, and the main ones among them include: one is there was lack of African technocrats who could give political direction to the country. When we talk about lack of political technocrats, these are the people who have knowledge on how to run the political affairs of a government or of a country. So when Kenya gained independence in 1963, there were no people who could understand the politics of any government or a country. So that was one of the problems. Another political problem which Kenya inherited from the colonial government is the divide and rule tactics employed by the British left Africans in Kenya divided. So that divide and rule tactic used by the colonial power during their colonial period was another problem, because at independence, African communities in Kenya remained divided. So it was a problem which lingered for many years after independence. So that divide and rule brought a lot of suspicion and jealousy among the different Kenyan communities, leading to tribal conflicts and many others. Another political problem is illiteracy among the Kenyan people. Many Kenyans at independence were illiterate. And so they lack or The literacy levels were very high. They were not able to read and write. So those are some of the few problems that those were the few political challenges faced by Kenyans at independence. So to better understand this is, at independence, Kenya adopted a multi-party democratic society, or they adopted a multi-party democracy system of government. And there were three major political parties then. One of them was KANU, that is Kenya African Union. Two, we have KADU. And lastly is what we call APP, that's African People's Party. African People's Party. These were the three major political parties at independence. KADU and APP formed the opposition, while KANU formed the government. And you all understand that during that time, at independence, as the two formed the opposition, KANU formed the government. We all understand this government was headed by Jomo Kenyatta. And he persuaded the opposition, that is KANU and APP, to join the government. And something to notice, this political party by the name KANU was majorly for marginalized communities. Marginalized communities then were communities like the Mijikenda, comprised of the Kalenjin, Then we have the Luhya and the Maasai. Kano was predominantly Kikuyu and Luo. While APP, which was led by Paul Ngei, was purely Kamba. So in 1964, Jomo Kenyatta persuaded KADU to join the government, and later on APP also joined the government. So by 1964, Kenya became a de facto one-party state. That means it became one-party state by fact that there were no opposition parties. So later on in 1966, the difference in ideology between KANU and other political parties led to resignation of Jaramogi Oginga Odinga as the vice president. And when he resigned, Jaramogi, that is Oginga Odinga, in 1966, formed the KPU, Kenya People's Union, that is the Kenya People's Union, as an opposition party upon his resignation. When he resigned as the vice president, Joseph Murumbi took over as the vice president from 1966. However, he resigned in 1967. That is Joseph Murumbi as the vice president from 1966 to 1967. He resigned. When he resigned in 1967, then Nyerere Moi took over. From 1967 to 1978, when Jomo Kenyatta died and he took over as the president. So these are the political developments. We've seen the challenges and the political parties which were there during independence, that is KANU, which formed the government, and it was predominantly Kikuyu and Luo. Then we have KADU, which was opposition, predominantly Mijikenda, Kalenjin, Luhya, and Maasai. Then we have APP of Paul Ngei, which was the Kamba. Then in 1967, all these two parties joined KANU to form, they quit opposition and joined the government in 1967, and that time Kenya became a de facto, normally say de facto, that is one party state by fact. Then we have, in 1966, Oginga Odinga resigned from government, that is from KANU, and formed a party known as Kenya People's Union. Joseph Murumbi was appointed as the vice president in 1966, but he resigned in 1967, that is 1 year later. And Daniel Moi took over from 1967 to 1970, when Jomo Kenyatta died and took over as the president. So those are some of the political developments and challenges from 1963 to 1991. But we still want to see what we call the political assassinations. Political assassinations. When we talk about assassination, is when a leader or somebody is killed for political reasons, we call that political assassinations. So an assassination is to kill suddenly or secretly, especially for political prominent or of a political prominent person. And the first casualty of political assassination in Kenyan history was somebody known as Pio Kama Pinto. Pio Kama Pinto. He was a nation and he was assassinated in 1965. That is 2 years after independence. It was a nation, Pio Kama Pinto. Another major political assassination is Tom Mboya. That was in 1969. Another major political assassination which shook the country was that of J.M. Kariuki in 1975. That is Josiah Mwangi Kariuki. J.M. Kariuki. It was in 1975. Those are the assassinations, political assassinations which took place from 1963 to 1975. To end up this part is, who are the major critics of the government?
That is
government critics. Government critics. Detail. One of the key personalities who were government critic was Martin Shikuku, who was MP for Butere. Martin Shikuku. MP Butere. Another one was somebody known as Jean-Marie Seroney, who was deputy speaker. Jean-Marie Seroney. Then we have Jelagat Mutai. MP Eldoret North. MP Eldoret North. And lastly is George Anyona, MP Kitutu. George Anyona. MP Kitutu. So these were the major critics of the government and they were detained. So we have Martin Shikuku, Jean-Marie Serone, Chalagat Mutai, and John Anyona. So generally, these are the political developments and challenges that shape the newly independent Kenya. So that was the end of our lesson.